in the Ivory Coast, that's part of prophecy. Okay, I just read in the news 800 people got killed over there in that Ivory Coast battle in one day. 800 people. Wait a minute, so why isn't Barack Obama going over there to help them?
Yeah.
That's all bullshit, man. That's all smoke and mirrors. Okay? But little did they know, they're getting get me Proverbs 21 and 1, I believe. Alright, because no matter what you so-called crackers do, you elites do, the Most High is making you do that. Don't think you crackers have your own free will. You don't.
Proverbs 21 and 1. The king's heart is in the hand of the Lord. As the rivers of water, he turneth it whithersoever he will.
Right, so it's the Most High allowing you, making you crackers go over there in Libya. Go over there in the Middle East. All right? Why? Because he's making you do what he wants to do. He's making you do according to what prophecy is. Prophecy says that you're going to go over there in Libya. You're going to go over there in Iran. That's what's going to happen. And prophecy also says that all you so-called white people are going to be slaves in the kingdom of heaven.
That's right.
So who you look down to, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, we're going to be your future rulers.
You said that the Most High is making them do that.
Right.
This is Revelation 17 and 17. For the Most High have put in their hearts to fulfill his will.
Right. Read that again.
Revelation 17 and 17. For the Most High have put in their hearts to fulfill his will.
The Most High put in their hearts to fulfill their will. All right? Heart in the Hebrew, that heart in this scripture, whenever it refers to heart, that means the mind. All right? And which goes back to the Hebrew word lab, which means mind. Okay? It doesn't mean your heart. Your heart can't make you. Your heart only pumps blood. It's just a muscle. That heart is talking about in the scriptures is your mind. So the Most High puts in your mind, you so-called elite's mind, what to do.
You know, that was it?
All right. Revelation 17 and 17. For the Most High have put in their hearts to fulfill his will.
So whatever you so-called crackers do, all right, whatever you elites do, if you think it's your own will, it's not. It's the Most High's will.
That was it, right?
Yeah, that was it.
This is the book of Daniel 4:17. This matters by the decree of the watchers and the demand by the word of the holy ones, to the intent that the living may know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men, and give it to whomsoever he will, and set up over it the basis of men.
Right, so it's the Most High that rules, and it's the Most High that's doing this, alright? It's the Most High's program. Alright? We're just actors. We're just playing a role. We're just robots to the Most High. Everything we do is according to the Most High. This is the Most High sim world, basically.
Sure.
Right.
It's going to set the basis of men.
Right.
This is Job 30, verse 6 and 7. Verse 7 and 8, Salakia. Among the bushes they brayed, under the nettles they were gathered together, they were children of fools, yea, children of base men, they were viler than the earth.
Well, who's that talking about? That's talking about you so-called white people. You're talking about you so-called white. You brayed, you didn't talk. You just sounded like, you communicated by sounding like a bunch of donkeys. Okay, and you braid in the nettles. Just watch Quest for Fire, right? Quest for Fire. You funny, man. You so-called white people is a fucking joke. The only truth you did was say it was in that movie. You basically exposed yourself of being a Geico caveman. All
right? That was it, right?
I got two for you. Go ahead.
This is Job 33 and 15. In a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falls, Slocky, let me read it again. Job 33 and 15. In a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falleth upon men and slumberings upon the bed, then he openeth the ears of men and sealeth their instruction.
Right, so that's the Most High. That's the Most High. When you sleep, he basically seals in your mind what to do. So you so-called elites, when you go to sleep and you think of what to do as far as going into Iran, all right, doing this, I'm going to take over Iran, I'm gonna make up this lie, I'm going to launch this bullshit as an excuse to go into Iran, that's the Most High doing that. That's not you. That's not by your own will. There's no such thing as free will. The Most High's will. That's the only thing.
This is Ecclesiasticus 33 and 13. As the clay is in the potter's hand to fashion it as he as slide. Let me start. As the clay is in the potter's hand to fashion it at his pleasure, so man is in the hand of him that made him to render to them as liketh him best.
Basically, that's the Most High. He has man. He can mold man. You know how you mold clay however you want it to. That's how the Most High deals with man. Whatever he wants you to do, whatever he wants you to do, he makes you do it. Basically, that's what that's talking about. So if you so-called crackers want to go over there in Iran, all right, if the Most High wants you crackers going over there in Libya, over there in Iran, guess what? The Most High is going to make you do it.
Can I say one thing? Go ahead. And that's also speaking for Israel, too.
Right.
Because the people come up here, we are on the highways, and we out here in the street. So people come up here and ask us why we out here, what the Most High set us up to. And that's it, really.
That's right.
It's our jobs.
This is the book of Jeremiah 27 and 5. I have made the earth, the man, and the beast that are upon the ground by my great power and by my outstretched arm, and have given it unto whom it seemeth meet unto me.
Basically, yeah, the Most High determines who's ruler on this planet earth. The Most High that's why the Most High's power is so great. You know what I'm saying? Because he determines everything. He determines everything that goes down. He determines a ruler. All right? So that easily, so I can flip it and say, what? You know what? The Most High, you people look at us thinking that we can't come back in the power. The Most High won't give us that power. It's the Most High's will, man. With the Most High, anything's possible.
That's right.
Anything's possible.
That's right.
So the Most High, he brought us low. He allowed you so-called white people, you damn Geico caveman, to have rulership over us. Guess what? The Most High can easily flip it and allow us to have power. Easily.
Job 33:14. For the Most High speaketh once, yea twice, yet man perceiveth it not.
Because the Most High, for example, you so-called white people, the Most High deals with you directly on the left-hand side. And first of all, you so-called white people, you're not a spiritual people, all right? You're a wicked breed of people, man. So when it says man perceiveth it not, that goes, you don't know that the Most High is putting that in your mind, because the Lord said the wicked does not consider, and the Lord is not in his thoughts. The fool said in his heart, there is no power. So you don't perceive that the Most High is making you do what you're doing. Devil.
In a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falleth upon men, and slumberings upon the bed, then he openeth the ears of men, and sealeth their instruction, that he may withdraw men from his purpose, and hide pride from men.
So you so-called white people, are you not proud? So that's how I'm just making a point through the Spirit, which is dealing with all men. I'm making a point directing it to you so-called white people. Because you are proud. So that's why you think when you do something, it's of yourself. All right? Which, that is total blasphemy. That's madness. That's void of understanding. The Lord set up you so-called white people to do what you do and to be in power so you can teach Israel a lesson and later just be destroyed. Because you wasn't chosen. You were just created to be a punishment tool from him. All right? Upon the nation of Israel.
Sword.
Right, the sword.
That's the spirit, the brother. You brought out the same scripture he just read. That's the spirit. The brother will come out, you know?
This is on Ecclesiasticus 10 and 14. 14 and 16. The Lord hath cast down the thrones of proud princes and set up the meek in their stead.
There you go. Read that again. That's the 10th chapter, right?
Yeah. Ecclesiastes 10 and 14. The Lord hath cast down the thrones of proud princes.
He cast down the thrones of proud princes. So what makes you think the Most High can't throw down your kingdom, Esau?
Right.
I'm talking to you elites over there, man. You elites. You Rothschilds. damn Esau, you sons of Esau, you sons of Cain. What makes you think the Most High can take down your kingdom? Read on.
And set up the meek in their stead.
And set up the meek in their stead. And who's the meek? You looking at the meek. The meek is the nation of Israel. You so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. The elect in the nation of Israel. Right? To be more on point. The elect in the nation of Israel. All right?
That was it, right?
More? The Lord hath plucked up the roots of the proud nations.
Plucked up roots of proud nations. You can't tell me you so-called white people are not a proud nation. That's why the Most High is destroying your kingdom right in front of your face. And you so goddamn proud, all right? You so-called white people are still planning 10 years from now. The pride of the so-called white man is incredible, all right? That's why the scriptures explain you to the teeth. Oh, but no, man wrote this. Man wrote the Bible.
And planted the lowly in their place.
And planted the lowly in their place. And who's the lowly? The elect of Israel. The people you look down on, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. We're going to be, you so-called white people, you other nations, we're going to be your future rulers, according to the scriptures.
That's right.
Damn it, approve it.
That's right.
That was it, right?
Yeah, that's right. This is Psalms 75 and 4. I said unto the fools, deal not foolishly, and to the wicked, lift not up thy horn.
Right. Wait, that horn is what? Read that again.
I said unto the fools, deal not foolishly.
You're the fools, you damn white people. You damn donkey making noise white people. Read on.
And to the wicked, lift not up the horn.
Lift not up the horn. What's that horn? That represents power. All right? Read on.
Lift not up your horn on high.
Right, on high. Because you're not the Most High. All right, you're not the Most High, you so-called white people. That's why what you did about of putting your image up there as the Most High and His Son and all the angels and all the prophets, that's blasphemy according to the scriptures. That's one reason alone that you so-called white people can't be saved.
That's right.
When all these other nations have rulership, they didn't have the audacity to put their image up as the Most High, but you so-called white people did. You so-called crackers did. That's why you so-called white people are going to be burned after 1,000 years of slavery.
Speak not with a stiff neck.
Stiff neck. You so-called white people can't do that. You cannot speak with a stiff neck. You're proud people. Read on.
Verse 6. For promotion cometh neither from the east, nor from the west, nor from the south.
Read on.
But the Most High is the judge.
Right. So the Most High gave you the promotion of rulership for a little season, though. For a little season, the Most High allowed you to rule on this planet Earth. But your rulership is coming to an end, you so-called white people. The Most High is taking that rulership from you. Read on.
He putteth down one and setteth up another.
So the Most High is going to take the kingdom away from you, so-called. I'm not talking about you average white people.
Right.
I'm not talking about you. I'm talking about the elites. The elites that own this society. That own this whole world.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah.
I'm not talking about you average peon. You average everyday Tom and Harry don't know a goddamn thing.
That's right.
As well as you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Puerto Ricans. All right? But the Most High, because the Most High gave the rulership to the white man, the so-called white person, he's going to take it from you. Read on.
Verse 8. For in the hand of the Lord there is a cup, and the wine is red.
Whoa, that cup is what? That cup is slavery. You so-called white people are going to get a taste of slavery.
Give me Isaiah 14. Okay.
You so-called white people are going to get that taste of slavery, and you're going to drink it all down, baby. All the way to the dregs. All the way to the dregs. You ain't go, you know what I'm saying, like some strong drink. You know, you sip it. Nah, y'all going to, a whole glass of that shit. Y'all going to taste slavery, man. And you ain't going to throw that shit up neither.
I'm going to read on down to 10.
Right.
All the way to 10. It is full of mixture. He poureth out the same, but the dregs thereof. All the wicked of the earth shall wring them out and drink them.
Right, right. That's all the wicked. So that's talking about you white people and all you other nations. You're all going to get a taste of that slavery.
That's right.
And it said it's made without mixture. Because you so-called white people did a lot to the nation of Israel.